Hello everyone, welcome to this session on BLSI design. Myself Dr. Sharmila, assistant professor, department of EC at Krishna Engineering College. So the learning outcome of this lecture is, at the end of the section you comes to know the brief history of IC, then evaluation of IC and about PN junction diode. So in the history, before we go into the history, first you have to know what is an IC. So IC is nothing but it is an integrated circuit in which more number of transistors are fabricated in a single chip. That is an IC. So in 1958, the first integrated circuit was built by Jack Kilby at Texas Instruments. He built a flip-flop using two transistors. Okay, so this is the picture of the first integrated circuit. It is built by Jack Kilby at Texas Instruments. They built a flip-flop using two transistors. Later in 2010, so Intel Core i7 microprocessor was invented using 2.3 billion transistors and 64 gigabyte flash memory. It has more than 16 billion transistors. Okay, so you just see the gap between 1958 to 2010. Still there is an sustained growth in the electronics industry, the annual growth of 53%. No other technology has this much constant growth in the history. Okay, so during the first half of the 20th century, they used a vacuum tube to build the computers and all. So the size of the vacuum tube is very large. It is very expensive and power hungry and unreliable. You know that in the first and second generation of computer, they have used your vacuum tubes and gas. The size of that first generation computer was very big. Okay, it is about one building size. Okay, so size of computer was very large, as well as it is very expensive and consumes a more power and unreliable one. Okay, in 1947, the first point contact transistor was invented by John Baden and Walter Burtin at the Bell Laboratory. This is a picture of the first point contact transistor. So in the 1947, they invented a bipolar transistor. You know what is the meaning of transistor? Transistor means transfer resistance. Okay, so it is mainly used to amplify the signal. There are two types of transistor, PNP transistors and NPN transistors. Generally, the BJT, that is bipolar junction transistor, is called current control device. Okay, the base current control the currents between the emitter and collector. So the main advantage of BJT is it is reliable, less noisy and more power efficient. So after the vacuum tube, they have used the bipolar junction transistor to build an IC. So the bipolar junction transistor is made up of a semiconductor device. In this there is no vacuums, filaments and bulbs and all, glasses and all. Okay, so the bipolar junction transistor is just made up of a semiconductor material only, that is solid substrate they used to manufacture the bipolar transistors. Okay, but the BJT has one limitation. If you are going for the high level of integration, that is if you are using a more number of BJT or fabricated in a single IC, means it consumes your more power. Okay, that is the main limitation of BJT. So the main limitation is, while in the ideal condition the circuits draw some powers, okay, that is the main limitation of the BJT. Okay, so because of this limitation, it limited the number of transistors integrated in a single chip. Okay, in 1960 they started to use a MOSFET, that is nothing but metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, to fabricate an IC. There are two types of MOSFET, that is NMOS and PMOS. So generally the MOSFET is it is a voltage control device. The voltage applied to the gate terminal control the current flow between the source and drain. Okay, so compared to BJT, this MOSFET consumes a less power, so high level of integration is possible. Okay, so in 1970s they started to use NMOS transistor to fabricate an IC. It is because it is very inexpensive, but it also has some limitation. It also consumes a power while in ideal condition. So these two are the fabricated using the NMOS transistor, that is Intel 1101 256 SRAM, Intel 4004 4-bit microprocessor. In 1980s, what is a major issue is the power consumption is major issue. While using the BJT and NMOS transistors, it consumes your power while in ideal condition. So from the 1980s, they started to use the CMOS. What is the meaning of CMOS is complementary metal oxide semiconductor. It is a combination of NMOS transistors and PMOS transistors. Okay, from 1980s to till now, they are using a CMOS to fabricate an IC because it consumes your less power. Okay, that means there is the CMOS process for low ideal power. While in ideal condition, it does not consume more power. So Moore's law, in 1965, the Gordon Moore observe that the number of transistors fabricated inside the IC is doubles every 18 months. Okay, he only made this observation. This is a graph of semi-log scale. Okay, it is a straight line. Okay, it indicates that the number of transistors using in number of transistor count you are using inside the IC is doubles every 18 months. As per the scaling law, what they predicted is, if you are reducing the size of transistor, it automatically consumes less power and cheap, as well as the speed is very high. So as per the, so what they are doing is they are trying to reduce the size of transistors because to increase the speed as well as it consumes less power and cheap. So next, evaluation of IC technology. So this IC evaluation of IC technology is based on the complexity of the circuit. What is the meaning of complexity of the circuit is the number of transistors using in a single chip. Based on that, the IC technology is evaluated. Okay. So first one is a small scale integration, that is SSI. In this SSI, the number of transistors fabricated inside the IC is 10. For the medium scale integration, that is MSI, the number of transistors fabricated in the IC is 10 to 100. For the large scale integration, the number of transistors fabricated inside the IC is 100 to 10,000. For the VLSI, that is very large scale integration, the number of transistors fabricated inside the IC is 10,000 to 1 lakh. For the ultra large scale integration, the number of transistor fabricated inside the IC is 1 lakh to 1 million. For giga scale integration, the number of transistor fabricated inside the IC is above 1 million. So based upon the number of transistors we are fabricating inside the IC, it is classified. So you know that what is an IC. So IC is nothing but more number of transistors are fabricated on a single chip. That is an IC. You know what is the meaning of VLSI? That is very large scale integration. It is a bucket load. Why they are calling it as a bucket load is more number of transistors are embedded inside the ICs. Okay. So you know that from the 1980s to till now, they are using a CMOS transistor in the CMOS transistor to fabricate an IC because it is very fast, cheap, as well as consumes a low power. Silicon lattice. Okay, so in the VLSI design, the most of the VLSI ICs are fabricated using a silicon material only because the silicon is available large quantity as well as it is very less sensitive to the temperature. So generally, the transistors are built on the silicon substrate. You know that the transistor is a silicon material only. So you know different types of examples of silicon material like germanium, silicons, gallium arsenide, etc. But most popularly widely used semiconductor material is a silicon. Okay, so for the silicon is a group 4 element. What is the meaning of group 4 is, so silicon has the 4 valence electron in the outermost shell. You know, for the semiconductor materials are group 4 material only because it has 4 valence electron in the outermost shell. Okay, from this lattice, uh, from the from this crystal lattice, you know that what is the meaning of crystal lattice? Crystal lattice is nothing but you take any material, each material has a more number of an atom. For example, if you are taking a semiconductor material, silicon semiconductor material, it has more number of silicon atoms. Each and every atom shares the electrons with the neighboring atom, in order to create a valence electron. You know, at 0 degree Kelvin, at the 0 degree temperature, the semiconductor material is act as the insulator. When the temperature increases, the semiconductor material act as the conductor. When the temperature increases, the electrons in the covalent bond get an enough energy and break the covalent bond and goes to the conduction band. Because of that only, the current flow will take place. That is, the current flow is depends on the recombinations of electrons and holes. So what is dopant? You know that silicon is a semiconductor material. If it is of pure silicon material, means it has no free carriers and the conductivity is very poor. Okay, for that only we are doing a doping. What is the meaning of doping? Doping means adding impurities in the pure semiconductor material. You already studied in the electronic subject. Doping means what? Adding impurities in the semiconductor material. Okay, if you are adding the doping, what will happen? It will increases the conductivity of the material. Okay, you know that there are two types of semiconductor. One is intrinsic and extrinsic. Intrinsic is a pure form of semiconductor. Extrinsic is a impure form. Impure form means what? The impurity is added to the pure semiconductor material. You know there are two types of extrinsic semiconductor, p-type and n-type material. In the n-type is the majority carrier is an electron. In the p-type, majority carrier is the hole. You know that in the n-type semiconductor material, okay, it is of group 5. Group 5 means what? Pentavalent impurity is added with the pure semiconductor material. In the p-type, it is of group 3. Group 3 means what? Trivalent. That is trivalent atom is added with the pure semiconductor material. Okay, so this is the crystal structure of n-type and p-type semiconductor material. I think already you have studied about these basic things in the electronic subjects. Okay, so next is the p-n junction diode. You know that the p-n junction diode is a basic diode for all the semiconductor devices. Okay, so what is the meaning of p-n? You know that the p-n means what? The p-type semiconductor material is joined with the n-type semiconductor material. So there is some electrical isolation between the p-type and n-type, that is called as a junction. You know about the p-n junction diode. In the p-n junction diode, the current flows in one direction only. So this is the symbol of p-n junction diode. It has the two terminal, anode and cathode. Okay, so in this class we saw some basic things about what types of semiconductor material we are using in the integrated circuits, and you know the brief history of the in IC, then evaluation of IC we discussed, and p-n junction diode also. In the next lecture we will see about the MOS transistor. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.